मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, मैं सर अभिषेक शर्मा फ्रॉम माउंट लेट्रा जी स्कूल झांसी। एज यू नो डैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड सिक्स चैप्टर ऑफ मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, सो टुडे आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू गो फॉर अ सेकेंड बुक, दैट इज इंडियन इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट। इन दिस बुक वी आर हैविंग 13 चैप्टर्स एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ दिस बुक। द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर एज यू आर सीइंग ऑन माई व्हाइट बोर्ड इज Indian economy on the eve of independence. What was the condition of Indian economy on the eve of independence? That is around 1947. What was the condition of Indian economy? So, as you are seeing in my whiteboard, I have mentioned 10 features of Indian economy. First point is stagnant economy. Second is backward economy. Third is agriculture backwardness. Fourth, industrial backwardness. Fifth, rampant poverty. Sixth, poor infrastructure. Seventh, heavy dependence on import. Eighth, limited urbanization. Ninth, semi-feudal economy. And tenth is colonial economy. So the first point is stagnant economy. On the eve of independence, Indian economy was completely a stagnant economy. Stagnant economy means which shows little or no growth in the income. Now, backward economy. Indian economy was a backward economy on the eve of independence. Backward economy is the one in which per capita income is very low. Third is agricultural backwardness. Nearly 72% of country's working population was engaged in agriculture. And food grain production was barely enough for subsistence farming. Fourth, industrial backwardness. There was a virtual lack of basic and heavy industries in the country. Production of machine was almost negligible or less at that time. Next point is rampant poverty. Bulk of population was very poor. People were not getting 2 square meals a day. They lacked shelter and clothing. Sixth is poor infrastructure. Infrastructure development, including means of communication and transport, generation of power was extremely low. In 1948, power generation was merely 2100 megawatt. Seventh, heavy dependence on import. The country had to depend on import for machinery and other equipment for the production. Armed force of the country also depends heavily on the foreign import for most of the defense equipments. Besides, several goods like sewing machine, medicine, kerosene oil, bicycle, etc. used to import from the abroad. Limited urbanization. Here, this point means at the time of independence, bulk of population of India lived in villages. In 1948, only 14% population was lived in urban or city areas. Rest was residing in the rural area. Ninth point is semi-feudal economy. On the eve of independence, Indian economy was neither wholly feudal nor a capitalist. It shows a mixed economy or a feudal, semi-feudal economy. Such an economy had a mixture of feudalistic and capitalistic mode of productions. Feudalistic mode of production leads to low production and low production leads to the backwardness. Now the last point you are seeing on my whiteboard is colonial economy. Indian economy was the colony of British's government. It employed exploitation of Indian economy for the benefit of the British economy. Following observation highlight how Indian economy suffered at the hands of British ruler. British government curbed domestic industry by imposing heavy taxes. Indian economy was used as a source of raw material for the British industries. Export of raw material was almost duty-free. Thus, natural resources of India were drained out for the growth of British industry. Atrocities were committed on the Indian artisan so as to force them to close their cottage industry. This led to the destruction of handicraft industry in the India. So students, today we have discussed 10 points which describes the features of Indian economy at the eve of independence. So start मेकिंग नोट्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड प्रिपेयर अ सेपरेट कॉपी फॉर इंडियन इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.